Welcome to Lair of the Alchemist, where we discuss all things heavy metal and hard rock. On today's episode, a review of the new King Buzzo album, Gift of Sacrifice. King Buzzo is Buzz Osborne, the guitar player and vocalist for the band The Melvins. The Melvins are most often associated with the grunge movement, but The Melvins were actually around for quite a bit of time before the grunge movement exploded, and they were very influential on a lot of the grunge bands. And when I think of The Melvins, I think of big, heavy, crushing riffs, down-tuned guitars, sludgy, doomy at times, stoner rock at other times, experimental with like noises and feedback and stuff, and Buzz's unique vocal style. So this album is the second solo album from his solo band, which he calls King Buzzo, and it is an all-acoustic album. It's actually listed as King Buzzo with Trevor Dunn. Trevor Dunn is the bass player for Mr. Bungle and has a whole bunch of other projects that he's involved in. And on this record, he plays only upright bass, either plucking it with his fingers or bowing it with a bow. The upright bass is what you would see in an orchestra. And between Buzz's acoustic guitars and the upright bass, it just creates a really great atmosphere to this album. There's no drums. There are some effects and stuff on the vocals, but it's a real stripped down record. But man, is it ever interesting, and is there a lot of like cool stuff going on? There's three instrumentals on the record. It starts off with one called Mental Vomit. There's one in about the middle that's called Junkie Jesus, although there's these distant kind of vocals with effects on them. I'm going to call it an instrumental. And the album ends with Acoustic Junkie. Some other highlights on the record, or one song that I really loved on the record, were a song called Housing Luxury Energy. What a cool song title, right? It sounds like Buzz is playing a 12-string tuned to an open chord acoustic guitar, so it rings out really big. And although there's only acoustic guitar on this, he does layer the guitar, so it gives it a really big, thick sound. And it has bowed bass in it that gives it this atmospheric kind of swirly psychedelic sound, a dark psychedelic sound almost. And Buzz starts off by singing in kind of a lower pitched voice, and it's very eerie the way he sings. There's a line in there, it's something like, I was 9 years old and I couldn't breathe. And just the whole song just has a ton of like atmosphere and creepiness to it. And later on in the song, Buzz goes up into his higher register, which is really unique. It's this really big sounding, belty sounding voice that he goes into. Really cool. Another one, I'm Glad I Could Help Out. Really, this is sort of in the same lines. It's got these creepy, crazy, like demented style lower vocals. He sounds like some sort of sinister madman, if you will. But there's these layered vocals, and this happens a couple times on this record. So there's like a layered vocal. There's like a really high-pitched vocal in the background, and these big strumming guitars and riffs, down-tuned guitar riffs on the acoustic guitar. I mean, if this was on an electric, it would be absolutely crushing. Here, though, the crushingness is in the sort of the atmosphere and the swirling, dark, psychedelic, trippy nature of these songs. Another great one is Delayed Clarity, which starts off the guitars doing like some strumming things, and the bass is doing like playing all these what are called harmonics, which are these really high-pitched notes on the bass, and he's playing them really fast, and it sounds like there's an echo effect on it, so there's just all these notes like swirling around. And the bass really adds such a cool element to this. The bass is never just following along with the guitar. He's always playing these counter lines. And when he's plucking, it adds this warm, deep, full bottom end to the sound. It just like lifts and beefs everything up. And then when he uses his bow and holds out these long notes and makes like effects and noises with the bow and the strings and the bass, it just adds this, again, this like just really out there feel to everything. And it's just, it is really, really cool. Another great one that I loved is Science in Modern America. Another one with these affected, layered vocals where he does this a few times on this record where it's the main vocal and it's real kind of like intense. But then there's these other vocals doubling it behind it, but they might have an effect on it or something. So it sounds like there's a couple different weird voices all happening at the same time. Just really cool. Bird Animal is another great one. It's got sort of this shouty monotone voice in it that kind of makes you like, again, because of the atmosphere of the songs and the no drums and everything, and then these shouty vocals just sort of make you like pull you back a little bit and really like, whoa, what is going on here? Just really, really neat. And you would think with just upright bass and guitar that, oh, this is going to get boring. But man, the songs just move along with the effects that they add here and there. It really keeps your interest, the effects on the vocals, the effects with the instruments and the way the songs just move. It never feels like it never feels like it's dragging or it's boring. There's a song, a fun song on here called Mock She, which is a play on the Kiss Ace Frehley sung song Shock Me. And he sings like the verses in Shock Me, and they sort of go into outer space. And the bass does this thing from Ace's live guitar solo where everything stops and he just does a ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-da-dum, ba-dum, ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, bum, bum. And he's doing it with the bow. So it's real aggressive. It's really, really cool. So if you're looking for something different, something heavy, but more in a psychedelic, trippy, dark, atmospheric, sinister way, check this album out because it is really, really cool. And it's fun to hear somebody experimenting and doing something different. And Trevor Dunn, just amazing on this, adds a ton to the sound of this. Buzz does with his vocals is so cool. He's got like all these different voices, a low speaking type voice, a more gravelly, low sinister voice, an up higher belty voice. So even though it's really a stripped down recording, it's amazing how much variety is on this. So I highly encourage you to check it out. It's a really fun recording that I really enjoy. Put some headphones on when you listen to it. You'll hear all this stuff going on. Just really awesome. So check it out. King Buzzo, Gift of Sacrifice. All right. Let me know in the comments if you've heard this album and what you think of this record. I think I'm going to be talking about the Melvins soon because this sent me back and I haven't listened to the Melvins in ages and I forgot how cool they were. So I'm going to have to do some episodes on them because even though people think that they're a grunge band, to me, they are just a heavy, heavy stoner, doom, metal, mixed in a little grunge band. They're a really cool group. So, all right, let me know what you think in the comments. Make sure you hit subscribe and like, and until we see you again, make sure you stay heavy, stay metal.